Okay, so we are live with Tron and Julie D, the morning DJ and the midday DJ from Legends 95.3 and 810. Well, Tron, why don't you give me your full name, first of all, and welcome to the show.
Sure. Full name on my driver's license and birth certificate is Richard Tron Simpson. Dad was a ham radio operator, and I called him a kind of a hippie nerd kind of guy. He and mom wanted to play with names, so they did that with my brother and I. So they always called me Tron. In fact, my dad had a dog named Tron before he passed it on to me. Tested it out on the dog. The dog came home at night. The rest is history. I am a Tron.
I think of Tron, and I think of the Disney movie from, what, the 70s sure. or 80s.
Yeah, I used to love the video game, but as soon as, like, all those 12, 15 tanks got on there, they just blew me away. Not a great video game player with a name like Tron, but I can throw a pretty good Frisbee.
There you go. And Julie D, tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm actually from Nebraska, and I lived a long time in Texas, and I've been a traffic reporter most of my career. And as you guys have heard my story recently, then I have luck staying in the air. But here I am doing middays in Denver now. So awesome.
Not one, but two, only one crash, but two aerial, wow,
mishaps. Yeah, well, we were going down in the plane no matter what because there was no engine. The pilot was yelling, "We're a glider! We're a glider!"
Oh, my gosh.
Well, let me ask both of you. Let me start with you, Julie. How did you first get interested in radio?
Oh, my gosh. So I decided I was going to go to college because everybody else in town had gone to college and I was still flipping burgers. So I showed up at admissions at the college and I said, I want to sign up. And they said, well, what's your minor and major? And I said, I don't even know what that is. So they gave me a big book and I sat in the lobby and I thumbed through all the pages and I went, this radio TV thing, I'd like to do that. That sounds fun. Here I am.
Wow. Awesome.
I know.
And that's kind of how I got started. I did radio in college, did my first newscast. I got off the air. I drove home in my MGA and just thought, this is it. This is my career, and went from there. What about you, Tron?
Well, I was doing everything. I went to college. I took psychology and English. Then I ran out of interesting classes, so I decided to dump college and go sell pizzas and flowers and those kind of jobs. And then I decided, well, I have a band, Tron the Band. So that was kicking off pretty good. And we were opening for some big acts. And I'm like, ooh, what goes well with a band? Radio. So I thought those would kind of live off each other. So I went to the radio broadcasting school and I got into it. And one of the guys who had me working, you know, you had to do the work experience thing before you actually got a job, so many hours. And I asked this gentleman, Dick Chase was his name, he's still around, and I said, Dick, I need to get work hours for the school, you know, school credits. He goes, how about if we give you work hours for that and we pay you? I'm like, I'm in.
So, bonus.
I don't know if it was all legit, but it worked out for me. I never stopped. It's been my first love of vocation as far as an everyday job, and I've never looked back. I've done all formats, the talk, the rock, the swing, the country, everything. I wouldn't change it a thing. I love it. It's great.
Yeah, I graduated from college, thought I didn't know, I wanted to get into broadcasting, thought I didn't know enough about radio or TV, so I went to broadcasting school, the KISS Broadcasting Workshop in Los Angeles. I grew up in LA, and then I went from there. What about you, Julie? Did you go to broadcasting school?
I went to Wayne State College in Nebraska, and that's what I majored in. But I actually didn't finish college because I got radio jobs, and I thought, why keep going?
Okay, well, you guys are playing music now, so let me ask each of you, whoever wants to jump in first, what's your favorite type of music, and maybe throw out a couple of your favorite songs that our listeners can maybe get a feel for where you're coming from musically.
Julie.
Wow. Well, a lot of times I've worked in the adult contemporary area, but that's not my favorite kind of music. I mean, I like some Stevie Ray Vaughan and, you know, the Eagles. And I mean, what a phenomenal show they put on. And, you know, probably 70s into the 80s, but not so much the pop 80s stuff.
And Tron?
I'm all over the place. I love old country, outlaw country, David Bowie, Doors, Eagles, classical, Wagner, Bach, you name it. I like it. The 70s one-hit wonders. Remember Undercover Angel? That was such a fun song when I was nine. And yeah, I'm all over the board. I like to play that music on the record. I like to play the music on the guitar. I like to play it on the drums. I like to hear it. Anything's good, except for Muzak in the elevator. I just can't deal with it, man.
Okay, well, let's get started here. We're going to test your knowledge, not of music from the 70s, but basically TV comedies from the 70s.
All right.
And let's start it off with our first question. We're going to start off with a musical, a comedy theme song, and we'll go from there. Here we go. Okay, that is the theme song to the 1970s TV comedy, Barney Miller. The title character of the show was the captain of the 12th Precinct in New York City. Who played Barney Miller? You asked this question earlier. Was it A, Jack Klugman, B, Jack Sue, or C, Hal Linden?
Tron, Hal Linden.
Hal Linden is the correct answer.
Good job, Tron. I can see his face. I just don't know his name.
Did you like the show?
He's still around.
I did. I liked Fish. Fish on the Barney Miller show.
Yeah, he ate Vagoda.
Yeah.
For years, they thought he was dead, and he's like, I'm still alive. Then he finally died. Nobody believed it.
Yeah.
Okay, question number two, and Tron is leading 1-0.
Song that we're singing. Come on, get happy. A whole lot of loving is what we'll be bringing.
Come on, get happy was the theme song to what 1970s TV comedy?
Julie. The Partridge Family.
Ding, 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 ding.
I was going to marry David Cassidy. We have the same birthday, for goodness sakes.
You know, it's funny. I had Shirley Jones on my show so many times. What a nice lady. Greatest TV mom ever, along with Marion. What was her name? Marion on
Happy Days.
Happy Days. Oh, Marion Ross. Yeah. Great ladies.
I love when Shirley Jones sang because her hair always bounced around.
Well, another question. Tied up right now, 1-1. The Partridge Family was about a widowed, you know this, was about a widowed mother and her five kids who form a band and make a hit record. Then they travel around the country in, it says here, a groovy school bus.
Oh, it was.
It starred Shirley Jones, as you mentioned, David Cassidy, as you mentioned. But so easy. Who played the oldest daughter? Was it Julie?
Oh, you're going to give us.
I can give you.
I know the answer.
Go.
Susan Day.
Susan Day. Ding, ding, ding.
Okay. Oh, yeah. I remember her. And then she was on shows in the 90s on those lawyer shows and stuff. Yeah. She was working all her lifetime.
Susan Day was hot.
Well, I guess she was. Good looking lady.
I even had to shower after that show. I'm teasing. It was a joke.
That was good. I liked it.
Keep a couple quarts in my locker at school. Yeah, but chocolate's getting old. Vanilla just leaves me cold.
Okay. That's Weird Al Yankovic, no problem there, singing I Love Rocky Road. This is kind of a trick question here. It was a parody of what 1970s hit song?
Julie. I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett and the Blackhearts.
Right, but wrong, because the next question, so you get credit for that. It was I Love Rock and Roll. Who sang the original version of I Love Rock and Roll in the mid-70s? You need help? You say, or do you want to jump in?
You know, it's funny. 3 years ago, a friend of mine at my radio station, we were talking about it, and I didn't know it until then. And I cannot remember who it was, but it was a guy. It was a guy singing. It was a group, and it's not Vanilla Fudge. I can't remember.
You want to go with Joan Jett?
Well, no.
Let me give you the choices: A. Pat Benatar, B. Joan Jett, or C. Alan Merrill and the Arrows.
Tron, C. Alan Merrill. That's it.
There you go. And later on, of course, Joan Jett did it, and that was the one that I remember and everybody else remembers.
That's a great question.
That's my only trick question, so you can take it easy. Here we go.
That's your question.
Who can turn the world on with a smile?
That's the theme song for which TV comedy that debuted in 1970?
Julie. Mary Tyler Moore.
All right. 3-2, Julie leads. Next question. Mary Tyler Moore also starred, easy, in a very popular 1960s TV comedy. Was it A, I Dream of Jeannie, B, Bewitched, or C, The Dick Van Dyke Show?
Ron, C, Dick Van Dyke Show. Love it. Rob Petrie.
There you go.
You have to fall over the chair now.
Yeah, exactly. You know, she was quite the gymnast.
Oh, Rob!
That's good.
Okay, this is not part of the quiz here, but who played the writing team? Who played Sally Rogers, for example?
Oh, Julie. Well, Rosemary.
This is not an official question. Just asking. Just.
I'm saying Rosemary.
Rosemary. And, okay, next question. That's the same song for One Day at a Time, a TV comedy that ran for 9 years, debuting in 1975. Bonnie Franklin starred as divorced mother Anne Romano, raising her two daughters, rebellious Julie, played by Mackenzie Phillips, and wisecracking Barbara, played by who? Need help?
Yeah.
She's done so many diet commercials. What's her name?
A, Eleanor Donahue. B, Valerie Bertinelli.
Come on, B, Valerie Bertinelli, married to Eddie Van Halen.
Oh, that's right.
Here we go. Next question. Can you name this TV comedy theme song from a show that debuted in September of 1978, starring, among others, Mary Lou Henner?
Taxi. However, I would have been wrong if you would have just let me go, because at first I thought it was Cheers when you said Mary Lou Henner, then I knew it was Taxi.
Oh. Ah! Which one of the following actors was not a member of the cast of Taxi? Was it A, Judd Hirsch, B, Danny DeVito, C, Christopher Lloyd,
Julie.
Or D, none of the above. Go ahead.
Oh, I would say A.
Answer's D, none of the above. Tron.
Oh.
Tron got it right. Tron is correct.
Darn it. Drat.
Take it a Skittle.
Can you name this TV comedy theme song from a show that debuted? Tron, go ahead.
The Bob Newhart Show.
The show, of course, starred Bob Newhart as a psychologist in Chicago. Suzanne Pleshette was his wife, and their friendly but strange, odd next-door neighbor was Howard, portrayed by Bill Daly.
Yep.
This question, though, Howard, co-starred on the popular 1960s TV show I Dream of Jeannie. Did he portray A, Captain Tony Nelson, B, Major Roger Healy, or C?
Tron, B, Roger Healy.
That is the correct answer.
Hold on. I'm a collector of Jeannie bottles.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, funny.
An unpainted one. I have all three seasons, all four seasons, painted by the prop masters years ago. But this is a 1964 Jim Beam bottle. And it still smells like liquor. 1964. What happened was Sidney Sheldon went into a liquor store and he was like, I'm looking for a bottle. I don't want to do an Aladdin's lamp. I want to find a bottle or something. And just happened to be that the Christmas 1964 decanter came out and he took this and he gave it to a painter and the rest is history.
Wow.
That is pretty. Can you put that up again?
Sure.
That is great. That is fantastic.
Isn't that fun? And then they put on handles, which are just, they're just not this one. And I found these when eBay started. I found them on eBay and I had to have them. And I became somewhat obsessed with them. So I have many of them.
Wow, that is...
I could just imagine all the junk you have around.
I have no idea. Wait till you get to Star Trek, Bill. Oh, my God.
Oh. Okay, next question here, next theme song.
I know what it is.
From Television City in Hollywood.
Can you identify this TV comedy theme song?
Great song, great show.
Julie, it's Carol Burnett, of course.
Here it is.
You got to tug.
Okay, here's the question. The follow-up question, though, okay, is which of the following people was not a member of the cast of the Carol Burnett show?
Okay.
A, Tim Conway. B, Lucille Ball. C, Harvey Korman.
B, Lucille Ball. Tron, yeah. Sorry, Julie.
We'll add up scores later on. Lucille Ball is the correct answer, Tron.
Yeah.
Two more theme songs. Here we go.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's a theme song to Three's Company that debuted in March of 1977. Our question, what was the name of Jack, Chrissy, and Janet's original landlord on the show? You need help? Go ahead, Tron.
Original was Mr. Roper.
Mr. Roper is the correct answer. The follow-up question. Mr. Furley took over as their landlord when the Ropers moved away. Who played Mr. Furley?
Tron, Don Knotts.
Don Knotts is the correct answer.
Oh, I don't remember Mr. Furley.
Okay, let's go with the final. I feel like I'm Karnak or something. Here, I hold in my hand the final envelope. Here's the final TV theme song.
May the fleas of a thousand camels infest your armpits. Yes.
Baby, if you've ever wondered whatever became of me, I'm living on the air in Cincinnati.
Julie.
It's a theme song from WKRP in Cincinnati, debuting in September 1978. Our question, who played DJ Dr. Johnny Fever?
Oh, I don't remember his name.
Need help?
Tron.
Howard Hessman.
Howard Hessman
is the correct answer.
Still around.
Last question, awesome. No theme song music. Finish this quote from WKRP receptionist Jennifer Marlowe, played by Lonnie Anderson, quote, I like older men because A, they have more money, B, they'll do anything to please you, or C, they tire easily.
Julie. I'm going to guess and say C.
They tire easily is the correct answer. Yeah.
Just seemed like something she would say.
That's a great line.
that was a show that my favorite TV comedy of the 1970s, and maybe yours too, because it was all about radio, right? When I was just starting to get into radio.
Right. You love know, Les Nessman.
Yes.
He always had a Band-Aid somewhere. And
it
we
did.
Used to, out of our helicopter for traffic. At Thanksgiving, we would throw, not turkeys, but we would throw gift cards for turkeys out of the helicopter.
That's awesome.
Oh, that's great. Well, Tron, you are the winner.